In this video, we will cover how to use the UI in 3D space. In addition, I will inform you of solutions to various problems that arise when using the 3D UI canvas. First, let's create a UI canvas. As we know, the canvas's default render mode is set to Screen Space Overlay. To display the UI in 3D space, change the render mode to World Space and then specify the event camera. The task of using UI in 3D space is straightforward, but now we face some problems. The first problem is that the canvas is too large to be used in world coordinates. I'm going to reduce the size of the canvas to 10 width and height. Then add the same image used in the screen space overlay. When I put the image used in the screen space overlay as it is, it will be very shrinked as shown on the screen. This is because the image is set to display as 100 pixels of the world size. Before solving the problem, we need to know about the basic units of Unity. Unity uses metric units for length. For example, one of Unity's basic 3D objects, cube, has a default size of 1 meter in width, length, and height. Therefore, the canvas in 3D space must also follow the metric system, and if the width and height units are set to 1, it is same size of the cube. However, because the pixels in the UI image are so low, we need to multiply the pixels per unit by 100 from the default to get the shape of the image we want. If we change the number of pixels per unit, the same UI image used for the screen space overlay will not appear in the intended shape. If so, the number of pixels per unit of the screen space overlay canvas should also be modified to 10,000. Fixing the problem this way is not bad, but there will be a lot of things to fix, so there will be more problems in the future. I solve it in a simpler way. If we simply change the size of the world space canvas to 0.01, which is the size divided by 100, we don't need to modify anything else. So, the image used for the screen space overlay has the advantage of being able to use the default pixel value as it is. Now that the UI canvas works in world space, this image can be rotated around 3 axes. Please note that each scale value of the canvas must be the same for the child UI element to rotate correctly. If any of the scale values of the canvas are wrong, the rotating UI elements will be stretched abnormally. Therefore, if you want to rotate UI elements within the canvas, make sure that each scale value on the canvas is the same. UI elements used in 3D space are drawn sequentially according to the order of the children of the canvas, as used in the screen space overlay. If you want to change the display order of images or buttons in a single canvas, simply change the order of the children. The problem is when the order of drawing is reversed depending on the field of view when using multiple canvases. The solution depends on what you intend to express. If you want to express the front and back sides of the UI, you can increase the distance between the canvases. This is not perfect, but it can solve some of the problems with the order in which they're drawn. To set the order of drawing a little more accurately, change the Z position of the image or button in the canvas little by little. By reducing the amount of overlapping moments in this way, you can solve the problem of the inversion of the drawing. Another way is to force the drawing order through the sorting layer or order in layer settings. If this is forcibly set, the canvas with high order is drawn first based on the camera's viewpoint. It is certainly possible to solve the problem, but this method should make the UI look only front. Like 2D or screen space overlay, using multiple canvases doesn't have a big impact on performance. Therefore, if you want to express multiple UI elements with different positions and angles at the same time, it is recommended to use the canvas separately. If you use this appropriately, you can create a UI that rotates in 3D space. That's all for today's video. Thank you. See you next time.